Good evening, everyone. Buenas noches a todos. Hope you're having a great, great Monday. And today's the 31st, and today's part two of the loot haul. And as you can see, I got two boxes right behind me. Well, not literally behind me, but right here in this side. And I have a package right here. So let's get to it. So this package is from Box Lunch. Now these guys are basically the nerdy version of Hot Topic. Hot Topic's more goth and emo, but you'd be surprised. There's some really good stuff at Box Lunch. I've actually wore quite a few good stuff from there. That Jurassic Park mug that you would see me often drinking, that one is from Box Lunch. So let's go ahead and make sure it doesn't damage anything. Trust me, I don't want to go over here and say, oh, I dropped something, cut something. Alright, so we got the receipts right here, and I got something cool. $30 off for any purchase over $60 or more. And I have until the 22nd to use it. Actually, I got a coupon on my last purchase, 25% off. And to be actually honest, I wasn't exactly sure what I wanted to buy. So I have till today to use it, but I got this coupon right here for $30 off. So why not use this one instead? So I'm saving this. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to put the 25% off down because I don't know what I could buy at that moment. So, and the thing is that I'm getting paid on this coming Friday. So I get paid on Friday and then I have a 3-day weekend. So there you go. That's always a good thing, huh? All right. And I got myself another 25% off coupon, and I have until the end of September. So I lose one and I gain one, so that's always good. Okay, so I got some pretty cool stuff around here. All right, the first thing is this is a Jurassic Park socks, a black backstripe socks. Now these are actually really cool. I saw these ones and they were in special for about $7, I think. Let me take a look. $7, yeah. Yeah, less than $7. So this is how it looks like. Maybe I'll show you how it looks like. It does have the colors of the trademark red, yellow, and black. So this somehow is reminiscent to the milk snake or the coral snake. So you can see this is how the socks look like. Let's look at that. There's the logo right here, and it comes with some cool colors. With the hazard, I think it's called the vector stripe on the back, and then has the red and yellow, red and black on the tip, near the tip. These are really cool. I'm actually gonna wear these ones. Probably, you know, it's funny. I was thinking about doing a really bizarre cosplay, and I might get to it. I might do it. I just might do it. I mean, this year has been, how should I say, a shithole of a fucking day, a fucking year, a shithole of an asshole of a fucking year, and it has been a really struggle for me, trying to find ways to entertain myself and find different ways. And for me, I found another skill that I've learned. It's not really much, it's called filtering. It's simply photo filtering. And for me, I haven't really used it much, but now with the different softwares that I use, or different apps that I use on my phone, I get to design all this cool stuff, and I definitely gonna do that more for cosplaying. I might do it for my own personal pictures. I am slowly learning how to do photography on my own, and it's fun, you know. It's just, it does require some time. Okay, so the next one is actually more of a woman's shirt. I'm not gonna wear it, trust me. I don't think it'll fit for me. So this is a really cool shirt. I saw this, and it is a front tie. It's a Jurassic Park front tie shirt. Now this is, I ordered large. I have a colleague of mine who's really interested in doing some photos. So I really like the stitching right here, the T-Rexes of the Tyrannosaurus right there. And there isn't much. I do like the design. I've always believed that Jurassic Park fit looks a lot more appealing as something more outdoors, like outwear. And the logo itself. So yeah, this is really cool. This one actually cost me $41, $45, I'm sorry, but it was discounted for a good price. I think it was for like it cost me $32, so I saved up a good $13. So that's always good. I definitely have a colleague of mine who wants to get into cosplay and get into photography. So if hopefully this one, and this is size large, like I said, so hopefully it fits for her. I really do hope so. Otherwise, I'm like, oh my god, she might accidentally tear it up. I mean, I'm not saying that she's large. She's just, I mean, too large. I'm just simply saying that it might be a bit, what is that word? A bit tight, a bit tuggy. You know what I mean? That you could barely do any stuff. I buy shirts from Hot Topic the other time. And the thing is that their demographic is more of slim, and I'm more a bit of a broad shoulder, so I'm a little bit more of the regular, if not, large, you know, a bit, tall and large. So for me, wearing an extra large shirt from Hot Topic might be a little bit too, a bit tuggy. Like, I feel like I'm being, you know, hugged. And for me, I don't really like that on a shirt. So I do wear a shirt size one or two sizes larger, so I can feel a bit more comfortable. Now, it does feel a little bit more, windy because of the excess. So I sometimes either tuck it in or I just leave it like that. But it rarely happens, especially when you wash it. So I usually go for one size larger. So I'm usually wear an extra large, but I do at times go for a 2X to play it safe. All right. So yeah, that's a definitely cool shirt. Now here, this is definitely something that I saw it. I'm not joking. When I went to pick up my mug, I saw something cool, and I thought to myself, oh, you know, it would be cool if they had a jersey of this. It would be badass. And next thing I know, I saw it, and I'm like, I gotta buy it right now. But I'm like, I don't have any, I don't have any money at the moment. I don't have a coupon. I don't have anything that could help me out. So I got a special from the Box Lunch app, and this one also was on discount. And I'm gonna show you. This is definitely something that I want to mix it up with my yellow stripe socks. And it's a soccer jersey of Jurassic Park. Now you have the engine logo on the side, on the left corner. I wouldn't say left corner, but like in the left side of the shirt. Plus you got Mr. DNA right there. I think he's flipping off someone or just pointing at himself. You have the awesome logo on the back, I mean on the front. Then you have the matching colors just like on the socks. And now you may think to yourself like, okay, is this like a certain, is there like a player name on the back, or is it just a plain old jersey? What's on the back? And guess what? It's Malcolm. How is this possible? I mean, this is basically the guy who said no to the park. So I think it could have been better if it was Hammond on the back. Or I would say Hammond would have been excellent choice, an excellent candidate, because he was the guy who brought the idea of Jurassic Park. So to have Malcolm on the back, it is a little bit bizarre, to be honest, because he's the one who says no, no, no. So, yeah, this is when I actually ordered 2XL, which you can see right here, 2XL, and this one almost cost me $40, but of course, because of the coupon that I used, where's my receipt, where's the receipt at? I just had it around here. Oh, here it is. With the discount, it only cost me $35. So it wasn't much of a drop compared to, $32, yeah. So it wasn't much of a drop compared to this one was $30. I'm sorry. This was $30. And the shirt itself was $35. I'm sorry. So the front woven shirt, the tight front shirt, cost me $35, which I saved $10. And then I had the jersey that cost me $30, and it was almost around $40. So I saved about a good $8 to $10, which once again, it's not a bad idea. It's a great thing. See, that's why I do shop at the store at times, but sometimes their specials are really selective. Like one time, before the last time I went there, they had a special for Game of Thrones, and I think it was about 30% off. And this was a time when the season 8 ended, and we all know how that turned out. So that's why they decided to give that little discount. I don't know if anyone bought anything from Game of Thrones, but it was a bit disappointing. It really was. But you know, what can we say? All we could do. So the next thing we got here is Amazon. And well, we all know what we got. Let's see what we got here then. All right, we got ourselves a hard hat. We got ourselves a hard hat, color orange. And we got ourselves the strap or the gear of the hard hat. We'll figure it out shortly. I'm in no rush to I think it's upside down. Yeah, well, we'll worry about that later, right? Okay, and right here we got ourselves a red polo shirt. Now extra small. What the hell? I thought I ordered an extra large. What the crap? Yeah, this is weird. I thought I ordered an extra large. But yeah, I kid you not, right there. It says extra small. Unbelievable, guys. XS. Seriously? Oh my god, looks like I'm gonna have to send in a complaint. But yeah, I ordered a extra large red polo shirt, and somehow I got an extra small, so it's not gonna fit on me no matter what. One time I wore one of my youngest brother's shirt, and it was size medium, and dear God, like here, I feel like I was being choked on. It was like, oh, it was unbearable. And I'm like, why is he wearing something that tiny? And I asked him that one question, like, why do you wear one size smaller? And he says, well, because I like to exaggerate. I like to show up my muscle. I like to make them look toned and large. And the thing is that he's not broad-shouldered. So for him, I think it looks a lot better. For him, he looks better with that. For me, I do need something, like I said, I do like to have something breathable. Something that I don't feel like I'm being choked or strangled. But yeah, this is actually disappointing, to be honest with you, because I was actually really eager to wear this, because there was this character I wanted to cosplay as, and he requires a red polo shirt, and now I have to go tell these guys, like, hey, I asked for an extra large, and for some reason you gave me an extra small, so. That's okay. I mean, as long as they could give me one, an extra large. All right, so this is from eBay, and I'd like to thank Brett from Champaign, Illinois for this. Now, this is actually something really interesting. So in case you didn't know, right here and up here, I am a big Jurassic fan, in case you didn't know. And there were some time that I couldn't able to buy the things I wanted to buy because of money. Of course, it's always tricky when you don't have the extra money lying around. When Jurassic Park movie came out back in 93, let's just say I wasn't working. I was only 10 when the movie came out, so I didn't know nothing about money. So, like, if I had money, I probably would buy a game. I probably would buy toys. And, you know, unfortunately, I don't think I ever bought one when I was that age. I think the first time I bought something from Jurassic Park was when I was, like, maybe 14 or 15. And I bought it at KB Toys at that time when it was still around. And I bought them on special for like $5 each. So I bought the raptor and the Dilophosaurus, the one where you could shoot water. And it was something, you know. It wasn't much, but it was something. You know, my cousins, Ricky and Andy, they're the ones who had all the cool dinosaurs. They had the young T-Rex, the red T-Rex. They had the Utah raptor. They had all these cool dinosaurs, and I'm like, damn, wish I had something like that going on, but never happened, so now I had to go buy them at certain prices, and for me, I'm not really looking forward to buying them in the box, because that will almost cost me about a full check, and trust me, I make some good money, but it's not something that I'm really eager to spend. Like, I must have it, despite of having a really pricey tag. So, yeah, it just never happened. So I'm slowly buying them here and there, no matter slightly, what is that word, worn or if not dispainted? I don't know, is it dispainted or unpainted? Not unpainted, but losing its painting. Of course, I could always retouch them, make them look semi-brand new, but it's fading. You know, their colors or paints are fading, and some of them are getting worn down, because, like I said, some of these toys has been in closets or in attics for quite some time, and I actually had some figures here and there that had a very bad fate, like my Tabra Jara that's right here. Let me, oh yeah, I can't show you. It's right there, and it's missing some of the toes. So it, instead of being like, how should I say, like this, it's like that. It's missing the main fingers like that. So it's doing double horns. And unfortunately, like I said, I had a bad infestation upstairs in my attic. And I had some mice that not only did it damage that type of dinosaur, but also several. And I'm still saving them for some reason. I mean, there is some sentimental value of it, but I just, it's such a downer because I know I'm keeping them. I had them since California, and now they're just bits and pieces of their former self. And that's what happens when you have an infestation. You know, just, you're not guaranteed that good things are gonna happen, you know, come out in great condition, but ni modo. So let's go ahead and open up this box right here and I'll show you guys what I have. So I'm gonna go ahead and open up here. Okay. We got some paper. We got some old newspaper and stuff like that, which is always good. All right, so this is what I got. Oh wow, they're really bulky. So I have the stalking raptors. Now I actually saw this one's from I believe from Laura Legends, who is another YouTuber, and she collects, she's a bit of a dinosaur, a bit of a Jurassic fan as well. And yeah, look at this. This is so cool. Look at how tall it is as well. This is a stalking alpha raptor. And this is how it looks like. This is big. And it looks in good condition. Brett, if I'm correct, if I'm saying this, yeah, Brett mentioned that there's some discoloration, that was the word I'm looking for, that there's certain discoloration because it, obviously it's almost a 20-year-old toy. So they said that there's some filth in here, like a bit of earth, a bit of sand right here, as you can see around the eyes. A little bit of soap and water will do the trick, but other than that, look at this intact. Right here is where the batteries will be placed, and you activate this. And now, the thing about this is that when you buy it by itself or in its packaging, it will come with the resonating chamber, which Dr. Alan Grant would use to call other raptors. Now, it's like a bit of a built-in whistle. So when you blow the whistle, it will activate the raptor. So right now he did say that the thing came with batteries. So even if I whistled, it wouldn't work. So it wouldn't, because there isn't any batteries. But it looks like double A's, if I'm correct, but I have double A's and triple A's. I will make a video later on, not later on today, but later on in the future, to show you how it looks like when it's fully programmed. So, and he gave me one hell of a deal, because he gave me two. I'm not joking. Now look at that. Same thing as well. There's some filth on the eyes. Now the neck is a bit wonky. So you can see here, there's a little bit of a gap. But definitely something I need to be very, very careful, very gentle. But other than that, everything looks good. Okay, once again, he mentioned that there was no batteries. So it's no worries, you know. Batteries aren't that expensive anyway, so. Yeah, thank you, Brett. I truly appreciate that. Definitely, it would be nice to have these two raptors communicating each other and trying to move around. Now, these two, like I said, these two came in a bundle in a 2-for-1 deal. Cost me about $17, like I said. So it was one hell of a deal. Now, if you get them packaged in its original packaging, now the thing is that some of these dinosaurs have it's like a fully covered box, just like the Brachiosaurus, but not all of them do. And this one have its own little stand for the raptor on top, plus the resonating chamber. But that's pretty much it. There isn't any protection around it that would avoid damage from the dinosaur, from the toy. So you have to be very, very careful when it's, you know, when you're placing this stuff around. And that will go up to like maybe $40 or $50. And a lot more expensive if with the resonating chamber. Last time I checked was like about $120. So, I mean, the resonating chamber, like I said, it's basically like a whistle. You could use any type of whistle to use as a substitute. You could always press your luck on eBay, see if they're selling a resonating chamber whistle to use. But like I said, any whistling from the mouth or your whistle device can do the trick. So that's pretty much it. But I had fun opening all this cool stuff, and this is mostly all cosplay related, so I am very, very eager that even though we only have 3 months to go by the end of to end the year, I am really looking forward to getting back into cosplay, because that is something that I've really wanted to do since March. So we shall see how that goes. I'd like to thank everyone for stopping by. I truly appreciate that. And I hope to see you guys in the next Luke Hall. So, see you guys next time.